my people. I have bring you people ogbonge news concerning what is going on in Nigeria right now at the judiciary. The judiciary in Nigeria is dead. The democracy in Nigeria is dead. My people, Nigeria is no more a country. Nigeria has been ruled by this Yahoo Plus politicians, APC, PDP. Recently, election that was held in February, everybody knows, even the deaf, the dumb, the blind, knows that Peter Obi won this election. We all saw what happened, how the policemen were carrying ballot boxes, how they were snatching boxes, how they were rigging the elections. Today, our judiciary has messed up. Judiciary, our eyes are on you people. This is the time to save Nigeria from this rubble that we are right now. Look at what happened in Kenya. Today, Kenya has been restored. Kenya judges stood up. Their judiciary stood up and give the rightful owner his position, the person that won election in Kenya. So what is wrong with Nigeria? Why can't Nigeria judiciary emulate Kenya judiciary, what they did? Millions of Nigeria came out to vote for the rightful person. And now they are reading the constitution. So Nigeria, they don't follow constitution, the government people, the politicians. They even break their own law. Nigeria politicians break their own law. Wike. It's only in Nigeria that I see that all the past leaders, governor, all the old politicians who has embezzled money, who has stolen money from Nigerian pockets, they are all walking freely on Nigerian streets today. Some of them have run to Western world to go and put their money there and come back and has position. Look at Ibori. Look at the chairperson in the House of Senate, Akpabio. Look at the people Tinubu selected to be his cabinet. They're all rogues. They're all rogues. They're all thieves. Today is the judgment day. Where is Tinubu? Is in India. Tinubu has never attended a court since this election rigging. It's only Peter Obi and the rest. This is the time the Nigerian youth should stand up and stick up for their own country. Nigerians, we are not ready yet for a better Nigeria. We are all still howling in corruption. Bribing and corruption has eaten up everybody in that country. This is the time all those boju pastors who are doing a magic miracle, this is the time they should start performing their miracle to make the country a better place. It's a shame the way Nigeria has gone. Our judiciary cannot be trusted. Our police officers cannot be trusted. Our politicians, they cannot be trusted. They are all thieves in wolf's clothing, and they now cover themselves in a human being clothing. My dear brothers and sisters, my viewers, watch video. Over to you. Watch video and tell me what you think and drop your comment. And I will see you in my next video again. And keep watching and thank you and God bless you and bye.
Take up the sustainable development agenda. And all those things encompasses the whole of whatever you want to talk about, human development. And if I remember very clearly, I think the first is on education, you know. The other is agriculture or something like that, water, health, and everything. So these are the things that we need to focus on in order to change the narratives, you know, of development in this country. And the sooner the better. The sooner the better.
Atiku, what him be this boy name self? This guy, which Atiku? Atiku never did there before. Which bet Atiku do? What you did talk, Shehu? This Shehu, your head correct, so Atiku cannot do better. From P2B manifesto, I think Obi will do much better. Atiku has looted, so Atiku cannot be president of Nigeria. All these politicians, they don't think how to better the country. All they think is just looting, looting.
Education, you know, the other is agriculture or something like that, water, health.
Nigeria is not working. People are there. APC, Tinubu, they want Tinubu to be president. Nigeria is gone. Nigeria country has crumbled. People are suffering. The politicians are just looting. Tinubu only just come to enrich his wife and his family. These politicians in Nigeria, they don't sit down and think, Nigeria, where is the way forward for our country? Where is the way forward for Nigeria to be a better place? These politicians, they don't think like that. These idiots, these thieves, these bastards, these vagabond politicians. Tinubu cannot take Nigeria to nowhere. This is very, very shameful. Which Atiku Abubakar? What did they worry did this shame? This shame self, your block brain, it correct, so? Atiku Abubakar cannot do no nothing. Stop calling Atiku. Atiku is a thief. He stole all the Nigerian money and go and establish himself in Dubai. Okay? Atiku cannot better Nigeria. Stop calling Atiku name. Either Tinubu. Tinubu is not fit. Tinubu is gonna destroy Nigeria. Nigeria is already dead. Nigeria is finished. Nigeria is a lawless country. Nigeria is a corrupt country. Nigeria is a zoo. It's a country where like it's animal that is living there. Animal is there. Even animal is more sensible than Nigerian leaders who are ruling today. Let us be honest. People are saying, hey, Tinubu now is Tinubu time. Tinubu will be president. You people are all, you are all idiots. Tinubu enter now is using billion to buy, to renovate furniture, to buy cars, billion cars, to buy cars for themselves. Why they are not increasing salary? Minimum wage in Nigeria for a family is 30,000 naira. Ah, God will punish you people.
Spend in all these areas, and that will really help this country. We need to put in place policies that would urgently address the issues that involve the mass of the people. It is the people,
the hardship, the suffering, the low income, the insecurity.
Not the rich, hey, the policy makers, not the politicians, the people. Those who will tell you, Ambassador, that we are not isolated from some of these inequalities that happen in the society. And you will, there is a public med policy in Brazil similar to this national social intervention scheme. And in other economies, that it happens that you have to be able to help the poor.
Shemu, you don't speak too much grammar. Are you not in that Nigeria, Shemu? Are you not seeing the poor people suffering? An average Nigeria cannot eat 3 square meals a day.
The controversy surrounding that social investment.
So the idea in itself is not a bad idea. It's the administration, isn't it?
Look, for sure, the implementation. And you know, what we're trying to do reminds me of what the Americans did under President Johnson. At every situation, they threw money. And it practically didn't work for them. And that was where the issue of policy analysis became a serious discipline.
I'm talking now about how we can use fiscal policies to cushion the effects of all this hardship. I'm looking at issues of taxation, for instance. How we can reduce taxes in some very critical sectors of the economy. The ambassador mentioned issues of health, issues of education. These are critical social sectors. What fiscal policies can we put in place to reduce the pressure of investors in this sector so that they can deliver quality health, quality education at a more affordable rate? And as well as those who are in the public sector as well. The use of taxation is also very important. Reforming the tax system is not just about revenue, it's also about making it easier for the vulnerable segments to be able to survive and cope with the current challenges. What segments of our population are we going to exempt from taxes? What segments of our SMEs are we going to exempt from taxes? Then we are talking of VAT, we are talking of company tax and so on. Those things are critical. Then of course we have the direct intervention, which some states have been doing. And that is also very important. Because from the reforms that has taken place, there's going to be a significant improvement in revenue. From the foreign exchange, convergence alone, annually we expect to see additional revenue of close to 4 trillion naira that will go into the federation account. So that means that each of the levels of government will have additional revenue. And my proposal will be that we should publish these allocations as they get them.
Oh, they will eat them, all these thieves. The politicians in Nigeria, they are thieves, armed robbers.
The states don't work.
Cannot work. The governors too, they are thieves. Everybody is a thief in that country. Thieves. Can you imagine Nigeria has police? When all these governor, APC, PDP governor come, they create their own police. Okowa police, this one police, Obaseki police, make God punish you now. Useless people.
In last six years, since 2019, I do not know any state government, and I start to be corrected, that has built an industry.
Oh, they don't create job. All they do is buying cars, building cars, go to foreign abroad to go and buy property. Can you imagine that?
So if they can just begin to do things, go into agriculture.
They won't do. They are thieves. I'm robbers.
Improve health.
They are thieves in power.
We begin to see significant changes the way things are. You look at the P2B manifesto. It was very emphatic to say that he would take up the sustainable development agenda. And all those things encompasses the whole of whatever you want to talk about.